Hello everyone, this is Alex from alexlancer.com, and in this video we will prepare our local environment to be ready to install and run our CodeIgniter 4 installation. So I will turn to my screen, and as you can see, I have navigated to the XAMPP page where you should select the file and the version regarding your operating system. So in my case, it is Windows operating system, and I have already downloaded XAMPP. Although I will not install XAMPP along with you, because it is already installed on my system. Once you install XAMPP, and please follow this order. First you install XAMPP, and then we go to the Composer installation. So we navigate to getcomposer.org, click on the download button, and if you are a Windows user, then just click on composer-setup.exe executable file, and this will download the file that you need to run for your installation. Once your XAMPP installation has been completed successfully, only then go and start installing the Composer. So click on Run, Install for all users. So click Next. And on this settings check page, you must see the path to the XAMPP installation folder, and where Composer has located php.exe file. This file is needed for Composer to run PHP commands. So if in some case your system did not locate this file automatically, go to Browse, locate your XAMPP installation, go to the PHP folder, and select php.exe file. So I will click cancel because my installation has detected the correct version. So click next. And in proxy settings, we don't need anything. So click next again. And when you are at this page, just click install and wait for installation to be finished. Again, my Composer setup is completed, so I don't want to override it. So I will click cancel here. You will click install. After that, we need one more thing to do. I want you to open your terminal window. So go to your PowerShell or CMD. And check if your system recognizes a PHP command. And you can do that by typing PHP space dash V. So as you can see, my system recognizes the PHP command, and it says that PHP version is 7.4. If in your case your command prompt gives you an error, then open your file explorer, go to right click on this PC, properties, navigate to advanced system settings, go to environment variables, select path and edit. So here you should see something like this. You should see the path to your PHP folder. Again, similar as it was in the Composer installation process. In Windows machines we have to define where the PHP executable file is located. So in my case, it is an H drive, XAMPP slash PHP. In most cases, it will be C drive. So be aware of that. Once you specify, so if you don't have this line of code, this line of this path here, click new, and simply you can type or copy paste your path as you have it on your system based on the XAMPP installation. So I will cancel it. Then you click OK. Again, OK. OK, close all the windows. We don't need this. So now, in order to check if the PHP installation has been, if the PHP path, variable path, has been defined successfully, first of all, you have to close the terminal window and open it again. So once you open it again, try php-v, and if normally you should see now the PHP version that is installed on your system. If you don't see that, restart your computer, and most likely your PHP variable will be available through command prompt globally. So once we have completed our XAMPP installation, our Composer installation, and our PHP global path declaration, we can go and actually install our CodeIgniter project. So we go to our XAMPP installation folder. Let's go XAMPP. htt docs, and you can hold shift and right click on Windows, or through terminal you should navigate to your htdocs. If you are on Mac, I don't know how you can open the terminal inside this window, maybe also with the right click. I'm not familiar with Mac operating systems. So in case you are on a Windows machine, then just hold shift, right click, and you will have this option, open PowerShell here. So you open PowerShell and leave it for now here as it is. So now open your Chrome window, go CodeIgniter for documentation. Open this first link that says CodeIgniter for GitHub user guide, and go to the installation page and select Composer installation. So at this section, installation and setup, copy this line here, open the terminal window that you had opened before, and paste it inside. So let's just change the project name, and let's say first CI4. Click, press the enter button, and let's wait for a couple of seconds for CodeIgniter to be downloaded and installed in our XAMPP folder. So while it's being downloaded, if I open my file explorer again, you can see I have here now, let me zoom a little bit, first CI4. So inside here I have all the files that are being downloaded of CodeIgniter. Yeah, the installation is done. So for now, I think we don't need this anymore. And let's actually see if we can run our application. So the easiest way to do it is, of course, by opening our XAMPP installation now. And let's start Apache and MySQL server. So once we have started these services, we can go to localhost slash first CI 4. So once we have navigated to this page, you actually see all the files and folders inside this path. But in order to see the actually CodeIgniter application running, we have to navigate to our public folder. Click on public, and here you go. This is our installation of CodeIgniter 4. But of course, no one would like to, even locally, to work in such a long path. So what I like to do when using XAMPP is to specify my working directory inside the public folder of CodeIgniter 4 installation. So how can we do that? Again, bring back the control panel, XAMPP control panel. Go to config, click Apache httpd.conf file, scroll down, and find these lines here that say your drive letter colon slash XAMPP slash htdocs. So these two lines here, they specify where will be the root of XAMPP server. What we want to do now, we want to override it by saying, so we want htdocs first CI 4 slash public. We want this to be now the root of our local server. And copy the exact same path in the directory on the second line in the directory option. So this you will not have in your httpd conf file. These are my settings that I have from previous projects. Usually you should see something like this. So save the changes in this file. You can close it now. And now you have to restart your Apache server so that it loads the new configs. And if we just refresh this page, you see we have a 404 error that is being generated by CodeIgniter 4 because our local host now is what we had before under first CI 4 slash public. So CodeIgniter 4 is installed, it is running on our system, and now we are ready to move to the next step and see the folder structure and understand the files where we should add our controllers, models, views to render the pages that we want to render. So, see you in the next video.